Hi, I want to take with you a quick in-depth look at the Salvation Army. Maybe you're a new employee with the Army, or maybe you're training to be a leader with the Army, or you're becoming a soldier or an adherent with the Army, or maybe you're just looking into the Salvation Army. Whichever way, I invite you to take this quick in-depth look at what the Army's about. And the way we're going to do that is to look at the Army's international mission statement. Several years ago, international leaders of the Salvation Army prepared this statement as a way of summing up what the Army's about. And I think you'll agree, it's very helpful. Well, the statement says this: the Salvation Army, an international movement, is an evangelical part of the universal Christian Church. Its message is based on the Bible. Its ministry is motivated by love for God. And its mission is to preach the gospel of Jesus and to meet human needs in his name without discrimination. First of all, the mission statement says that the Salvation Army is an international movement. It began in England in 1865, but today the Salvation Army operates in more than 130 nations around the world. You know, if you went to Kenya, the Salvation Army in Kenya has more than 230,000 adult members. It's been said that the Christian Church is the most multicultural movement on earth. Well, the Salvation Army is part of that Christian Church, and certainly the Salvation Army is not just a national church, it's a very international and multicultural. But when the Salvation Army leaders say it's international, they don't just mean that the Army operates in lots of different countries. What they mean is that wherever it operates, it's always one army. If you belong to a Salvation Army corps or church, then your corps has the same theology as any other corps in the world. It has basically the same mission as every other corps in the world. It'll be expressed in different ways, but it is the same mission. Every corps in the world supports the self-denial appeal. People wear some kind of uniform. They have the flag, they have the red shield. All corps in the world, all centres in the world, social services centres and everything else, we all serve under the one international leader, the one general. The Salvation Army is one international movement. Now for the second part of the mission statement. It says the Salvation Army is an evangelical part of the universal Christian Church. Now what does evangelical mean? Well, it comes from the Bible. The Bible, the New Testament part of the Bible, was written in Greek. And in the New Testament, Greek New Testament, you'll find the word euangelion. For example, the first verse in the Gospel, Mark says, "This is the beginning of the euangelion about Jesus the Messiah, the Son of God." Now, what did he mean? Euangelion means good news, good news. So Mark was saying, this is the beginning of the good news about Jesus the Messiah, the Son of God. And then he went on to tell the rest of the good news. The good news. Now, years, centuries ago, in English, when they spoke Old English, good news was Godspell. And that got compressed into the one word, gospel. So gospel comes from the word Godspell, which means good news. So Mark was saying, this is the beginning of the good news about Jesus. Now, from euangelion, we got the word evangelism, which means to tell people the good news about Jesus. And we got the word evangelical, which describes a tradition in the Christian church over the centuries of people who place a lot of emphasis on the good news about Jesus. You'll find amongst evangelicals that they emphasize the Bible as the word of God. They emphasize Jesus and his cross. They emphasize his salvation that he offers. And they emphasize the importance of being born again and of sharing the good news with others. The Salvation Army is an evangelical part of the universal Christian church. So we're not alone. We're one church amongst many others, including the global church of all who belong to Jesus. Now, the mission statement then, after that, moves on to consider three M's, the message of the army, the motivation of the Salvation Army, and the mission of the Salvation Army. First, the message. The mission statement says its message, the army's message, is based on the Bible. Now, what is the army's message? Well, John Gowans, General John Gowans, was a wonderful Salvation Army leader. And he wrote a song. There is a message, a simple message, and it's a message for us all, for all the world. There's a Saviour, and what a Saviour! There's a Saviour for us all. Let's look at Jesus, for He's the Saviour, and He will answer when we call. Let's look at Jesus, for He's the Saviour. Yes, He's the Saviour for us all. Well, John Gowans was saying there very simply, what is the essence of the message of the Salvation Army and indeed of the whole Christian Church? There is a Saviour and His name is Jesus. And He's a Saviour for us all. Now, where did we get that message from? Well, it didn't come from William and Catherine Booth or the Salvation Army, didn't dream it up. Jesus Himself went out proclaiming good news and saying the kingdom of God has come. And then after Jesus was crucified and God raised Him from the dead, and God sent His Holy Spirit and began to offer salvation to all, Jesus' disciples and followers began to spread out into the nations, announcing the good news. And then, inspired by the Holy Spirit, some of them wrote it down, and their writings became the scriptures of the New Testament. And that's where the army gets this message from. This applies not only to the message, but also to the ethics of the army and the principles on which it's governed. Now, sometimes ethical questions can be very complicated and they need a lot of thinking through and talking through. But always, we don't go beyond or in contradiction to the Word of God, the Bible. That's the next part of the mission statement. Now, after the message, we look at the motivation. What's the motivation of the army? And the mission statement says that the army's mission is motivated by love for God. There was a time when the army had a catchphrase, heart to God and hand to man. And it was like, at the heart of it all is this personal connection and the corporate connection with God. That God loves us and that God pours His love into the heart of someone who trusts Jesus. And that we want to love God back. And when we have that heart connection with God, love to God, inevitably, we will love other human beings. We will pour out the love that God's given to us. It'll overflow and we will love others. We will recognize that God created all people in His image, so we will love all people. Heart to God and hand to man, heart to humanity. That's the motivation, the source of the motivation of the Salvation Army. Now, next is the army's mission. What is the army's mission? The mission statement says it is to preach the good news about Jesus and to meet human needs in His name. Now, when the Bible says preach there, it's really taken that word from older translations of the New Testament, where it will talk about how Jesus went out preaching the good news, or Jesus said to His disciples, go and preach the good news. But the Greek word doesn't just mean preach in church. Preach a sermon. It means go and tell. Go and announce the good news. Go and proclaim it. One translation says, go and share the good news about Jesus with everybody. So there's all sorts of ways in which we can go and tell people what God has done for the world in Jesus and what God is now offering the world. And that's the first part of the Army's mission. But as you hear, the Salvation Army's got two parts of its mission: to preach the gospel of Jesus Christ and to meet human needs in his name. So it's a huge part of the Army's mission is to meet human needs in Jesus' name. Now, how do those two parts relate to each other, we might ask? How do they relate? The great British Bible teacher John Stott once talked about this, and he suggested that they are rather like the partners in a marriage or dance partners, in that they belong together. They belong together, and yet they're two individuals. Now, sometimes you might meet someone who says, well, we don't actually need to say anything. We just, if we live the life, people get the gospel. Or people might say, well, you know, the Salvation Army, how do we preach the gospel? By meeting human needs. By meeting human needs, that's how we proclaim Jesus. Well, but that's really saying that this side of the mission can do that side's work. It can live its life, and it can't. The Bible says, how shall they ask him to save them unless they believe in him? And how can they believe in him if they have never heard about him? And how can they hear about him unless someone tells them? Faith comes from hearing this good news, the good news about Christ Jesus. John Larson was a marvelous man and general of the Salvation Army. And he once said, William Booth said that the Salvation Army is like a bird with two wings. With one wing, it preaches the gospel of Jesus Christ, and with the other wing, it meets human needs in his name without discrimination. Booth said that unless both wings are in operation, the Salvation Army bird will not fly. How important it is that we keep that vision in every Salvation Army centre, that both wings are in operation. Now, finally, we come to the last part of the mission statement, where it says that the Salvation Army does its mission without discrimination. I want to put a positive twist on that and say that the Salvation Army does its ministry to everyone, to everybody. Jesus once said, for God loved the world, so much that he gave his only Son, so that everyone who believes in him may not die, but have eternal life. Well, if God loves the world and Jesus died for everyone, then we want to love everyone and include everyone and welcome everyone. There's a song, Darlene Check, wasn't it, that said, nothing you can do can make God love you more, and nothing you have done can make him close the door. God's love is for everyone, and the Salvation Army is for everyone. That's borne out in our history. About 1881, in the East End of London, in the core in Whitechapel, a mother of five named, I think it was Elizabeth Cottrell, she counselled a girl who'd come to the mercy seat. The girl, she discovered, was a sex worker. She was only a teenager, maybe 15, and she'd been more or less trafficked into sex trade. And Mrs. Cottrell said, well, you can't go back to where you've been living. Where can I get you to stay? She couldn't find anywhere for her to stay at that time of night where they were. She said, I'll take her home to my house. And she did, and she actually let her husband was at work, shift worker. She put her in her own bed. Now, the next morning, she found accommodation and work for that girl, a servant in a house. And then she got an idea, you know, there's more girls like this. So she began to advertise, put out word, you can come to my house to escape. And all these kids who'd been trafficked into sex started coming to her house, and then the house would be crowded with these kids. And then Miss Elizabeth Cottrell would spend the whole day walking all over London trying to find homes that would offer these girls work as servants and so on in their house. One time she was in a meeting and she saw this boy, a teenage boy, and she went over to him and he was very distressed, and she said, you know, God loves you, God can help you, mate boy, you know, mate. And he said, I'm not a boy. She said, I'm not a boy, I'm a girl. And this girl, and she said, I've just been performing at a theatre across the road. And this girl, again, she her only put the woman who'd kind of raised her had now gone to jail. And this girl too, she was desperate. And she'd kind of been put into a contract with this theatre, and she had to act as a boy. Well, Mrs. Cottrell couldn't afford to buy her out, and so she used to go to the theatre every day and stand in the wings while this girl performed, and then they'd go into the change room afterwards. There was one change room for males and females, and she'd stand there and protect this kid until she could find a place for her to go. And this girl found a happy life. She later got married. She lived a happy life. That's the beginning of the Salvation Army. No discrimination, because God loves everyone, and Jesus died for everyone, and we're there for everyone. So that's the international mission statement of the Salvation Army. And I, for one, think it's a pretty good God-raised-up Christian church and movement. God bless you.